Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back. So we're going to pick up right where we left off. Let's give it the test now that I've exited the game. Oh, it still holds. Let's put a frame. Still good. Hey, there's a mountain man. Let's go take him out. Hello, Mr. Mountain Man. Do you have an auger pot for me? Whoa. These guys are tough. A silver nugget. We'll take your silver nugget. Alright, so let's scrap. Scrap you and you. Scrap you too. I'm gonna take these back to the base. Take all of this back to the base. We're gonna make a little trip back over to. We're going to take our snowballs with us in case we get in a snowball fight. What we're going to do today is we're going to do a bit of mining. And might as well take our gas barrels with us as well. We'll leave the concrete mix over here. We're going to do a bit of mining and get some iron and some stone. Because we are very short on that. And let's see, we'll carry this little bit of stone, though I think we still have some over there. Because we're going to need a ton of concrete mix and just as much iron for steel. We have a little bit of steel there, I'm going to leave that. I don't know why this is not stacked together. But pretty excited about the idea of a new design here. I got on the server today and made like a very mini version, like a 3x3 version of this, and kind of tested it out against a few zombies just to see what would happen. And actually have something else new that I want to do to it, maybe, if we can find enough resources. But it is almost 2200, so let us get on our bike and ride. There's another mountain man. Let's see if we can take him out real quick before 2200. Little gold nugget. There's another one. It's about to be go time here with the bell about to sound. 2150. Goodness. Tough, tough, tough. Yeah, we'll take that silver nugget and we'll get back on our bike before that horn blows. Alright. Make sure we need to go. Yep, we're going right. Don't want to fall off a cliff. You know, we didn't mark that place. Oh, it's easy to see. Okay, I see it now on the map. Very easy to spot. I think there was a bag somewhere out here. It's right there. Really, lady? All right. Whoa, little evil Knievel there. So, let's run into a car, a tree. Hopefully we can run into a pocket or two of iron. I'm sure we most likely will. Make that easy on us to acquire. Fortunately for us, we did not wrench up all of the forges in this base when we created our new hub city base a while back. with after we did replant the tree farm, so we're good on wood. Let's see here. Anything in there of worth? This has been a great little base for us right here. This thing has taken a beating. And it still stands. So, what we can do is we can make this one our stone forge. Of course, we could make another forge if we had to. Don't have much of anything here. Let's see how much stone we have. Oh, we have a good amount of stone. One thing we don't have is a cement mixer. So we might have to eventually go back over to the hub city and make one of those to bring back over here with us. Of course, you know, honestly, we could do that right now while it's nighttime. And let's see here. What else do I want to put in there? We're going to scrap you. Scrap you. Scrap you. Kind of see what we had where. Well, it's a bunch of scrap right there. We did have a decent nail gun. Let's stick our bullets in there. And how much gas do we have left here? Yeah, we have enough. Decent amount. There's our mini bike, or emergency mini bike. Don't have a lot of wood left. How much iron do we have? Oh, look at all that iron. I forgot that we left that. Let's get that cooking up. Right now. And the other thing, do we have any clay here? Do we leave any clay behind? I don't think that I did. No. So we'll have to restock and resupply here just a little bit. But for the most part, we left ourselves in a good place with this base. Tell you what, it was just a tiny little bit of clay. We'll hold off on that. We don't have any steel. But we can make 160 of it right there. And we will turn this one into our stone forge. Like so. Do a little sort feature. So I tell you what. There's some bandages that I could throw on me in case I get cut. So we have 376 murky water over here. Well, we left ourselves a fireplace too. Nice. I didn't realize I'd left so much water behind. Oh, but we don't have a pot. We don't have a workbench either, so we could make one here. We'll cancel that. You know what, we'll hold off on the steel because you never know what we might need. We do have a little bit here for repairs and such, so we might better hold off on that. All right, now let's do the bottled water. And have all this snow. And I was thinking, well, we'd make some water to have for over here, but not gonna really need that. Have some beer. All right, so what we can do is we can go back, lots of canned food to eat. Oh, we had a fire right there too. I take that over to the new construction with us. We can head back over to the hub city and make ourselves a cement mixer for over here. That way we have all that we need. We can drop our brass and our bullets off and that type of stuff too. It's better than just hanging out in a base overnight and wasting all of those hours. You want to keep busy. You want to keep going. You never want to just stand around and waste time, as this is a time management game. You'll get yourself in a bind if you waste too much time. So let's do that. Let me check this one more time. We can go ahead and take that back. I probably could make, but it's going to take time to do that. I was going to say I probably could make a workbench for over here. Pick up cement. Oh, what am I doing talking about a workbench? It's right there. I thought I had wrenched that up. You know, I've walked by it like two times now. And all right, so we'll take that back with us. So we just need the cement mixer. Maybe another forge would come in handy. We could do two cement with one iron, because we don't need any you know what, we're going to make two forges as well. May as well have two. But you know what would be fun? I was thinking too, before I started the episode today, is to upgrade this base again. Not upgrade, but repair. And take on a horde here in this little base now with the spawn turned up and see how chaotic it gets. So maybe we do that. Maybe we revisit this base. Hey there, Mr. Zombie. Mrs. Zombie. Oh, don't do that. Don't you do it. Oh, really? Ooh, you're bleeding. I'm gonna go down here and grab a bandage. Hopefully the gamma is good now. Compared to before, had a few complaints about gamma not being bright enough to be able to see what's going on. Really don't want to put down any more lighting than I can help, because it does chew into your frames per second. Of course, we don't have an issue here on single player. It's mostly only multiplayer that you get those frame per second issues. There is an airdrop right up ahead here. It's off here somewhere. Ooh, that's a pretty steep drop off. Oh, there it is right there, though. We might as well grab that since we are here. We have a little train of zombies coming. Can we get back up here? I don't know if we can get back up here or not. I guess we're gonna find out. Whoop, right on out of there. That's bad news. All right, well, I think we got a sniper rifle and some other items. We'll take a look at that when we get back to the base, see what we did pick up. I saw a purple sniper rifle there. Maybe got some health kits. I was a little concerned about the zombies more so than I was what I was picking up out of the airdrop crate. So we're going to have a good many of those crates to go around and pick up. Someone told me the other day, Spartan, go around and pick up all your airdrops. You know, we could spend an entire day driving around picking up airdrops, because I have not picked those things up in quite some time. They're really beneficial early game. You know, it helps to get you a kickstart. You get some necessary patterns. I'd have to look back through the episodes, but I think we got the auger schematic from an airdrop, maybe even the mini bike book. But they're good for things like that early game that helps to speed the process along, and later game not as beneficial. You know, on the server I think we went for like 300 days without picking one up, maybe around 200, and then Old Crow when his made his way around and picked them all up And goodness, that probably took him days and days to go around and gather all of those. And I don't think we used any of the stuff that we got from him either, so kind of a waste later game. And maybe I disable them at some point now because they're just more of a nuisance popping up on our map than they are a benefit to us. But if I see one here or there right next to the road, I'll go scoop it up real quick. Let's see here. Nope. Do, 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 do. Oh, that's empty, so we must have grabbed that on the way over here. Make this little trip. So we need cement mixers and a forge. We could probably get away with just one cement mixer and two more forges. That way we can have two stone and two iron going at all time. Maybe even bring a chainsaw back, assemble another chainsaw so we can leave one here and then have one for this base. With that 45,000 wood in that tree farm, we'll absolutely need a chainsaw to cut that down with so it doesn't take us, you know, 20 minutes to cut down the whole thing with an axe. All right, the soothing sounds of 4 a.m. 4 a.m. around this household. We're still in bed asleep. Mr. Sandman, bring me a dream. All right. You know, when's the last time we went to the shotgun store? While we're just driving by it, let's swing up in there and see. I think we stopped by there a couple days ago, but yeah, my days get so messed up with playing on here, playing on the server, playing Empyrean. I just don't remember. Oh, look at that. Untouched. Do, 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 do. Oh, the sniper parts, pistol parts. AK, we'll take that. So we should have, ooh, an AK barrel. We should have enough parts now to kind of hold us over for a while. I tell you, since that is respawn, what's our inventory space? We need to go back to the base. Throw all that out. Don't need that. We'll go back to the base and drop this stuff off. We'll hit the hardware stores on our way back over to the oh, that's a cop. Gotta get out of here. Cop and a dog. So we'll hit those hardware stores on the way back over and see if we can't get ourselves an upgrade for the auger. You know, our parts and all are wearing down a little bit, and be nice to get that thing on up to 600 eventually. I don't know if we'll ever actually see that as much as we use it. Nope. You all know what I'm looking for in those bags. Kind of looking off at an angle here so I can get a good view of the, perhaps the bags here along the way. Ooh, I'm overheating because I have that puffer coat on. I need to slip that thing off. Do that right now before I forget. I have another cool idea, something I saw on a stream the other day. One of the members of the stream team that I am on gave a little preview to it, and I want to try that out. Let's go ahead and stash away our guns, our gun parts. Not going to need any of that stuff right now. Do a little Sodorowski. Throw our brass in here. You know what? We could actually just probably throw that into the forge. There's nothing else in there. Like so. Get our bullets put away. It's the only bullet that we had. Okay. Do a sort, assess what I have here. We'll take the antibiotics with us. Chainsaw. Looks like we may be taking this chainsaw with us for the trees. Might go ahead and get some more gas cooking up. We're going to need chainsaw parts. I don't think I have a blade anywhere to throw on there. Had the little open sign, open for business. Let's see. Cement mixer. What do we... You know, that's the one thing. I might have to make it over to the other base because we do have a small engine over there. Let me look through and see what we have here. Spring, forged iron, mechanical parts. No engines here. So we need... Take that. Let me look at it one more time. So we take 20 mechanical parts and 50 forged iron. Okay, our forged iron's down here. And I think we had some forged iron at the other base, so it's not a big deal. Oh, you know what? We needed 50, so... A little bit of steel here, but we might hold on to it over here. I don't know. Let's just take it. We'll just take it. We can always bring it back if we need to bring it back. We're going to throw our mini bike part there. So we can make ourselves another mini bike. As a matter of fact, let's combine these things here and consolidate space that we have. We don't need a whole lot of these parts just lying around. I think those handlebars are better than the ones on our bike. Okay, there we go. Little sort function feature. Don't need anything there. We are going to get some more fuel going. Have all the parts for the cement mixer. And... Yeah, we'll wait on that. Gas. We're going to need gas for sure. We have a workbench over there. What is this looking like? It's looking like it's out of stone. So, let's fix that little issue. Like so. I take some of that back with us. Still overheating. Let's just plop it in here for the time being. I don't know how long it takes to make the cement mixer. I guess I can click on it and see, but I should have left my tools over there. I don't know why I brought those and the pillars with me. As a matter of fact, let's stick these on here. Like that. We have no concrete mix left. gas has been paused. We're out of wood again. It's only 2,000 left there. Let's stick another 1,000 stack up in there, heck. Take a bite of this. I tell you what, we could make some. We'll take a little bit of corn with us to make some meat stew. Because you know how I do. Don't really need any goldenrod tea. It's good for the wellness, but we're going to be fine over there. We'll just drink water. Go ahead and get this into cornmeal. Okay. Well, I think that pretty much does it for us over here. First aid kits, we have a couple over there. Forges. Well, let's just use some of this animal hide. Gonna make two of those. And then for the actual forge, we're gonna need clay, the bellows, and a short iron pipe. We better take, okay, so we only need one each. We'll just get our stone and our clay when we get over there. I can just auger some up. I guess, how much does it take? 50. Might as well just take everything we need now. That, but we are going to need to get some clay because I think we're out over there. Don't have any left. Let's make this all into gas barrels. Drop off the extra 115 in here for space. All right, so I think that's as efficient as we can be. Let's do a sort. Plenty of gas. We have our bellows are going to be ready soon. We can make our forges. We can make our cement mixers. Let's just click on this to make sure we can make the cement mixer with what we have in our inventory. What are we missing here? Oh, the engine. Okay. You know what? Do I have... I don't know if I have the wrench on me or if it's in the... mini bike, but we could wrench some cars, most likely get an engine that way, and we come back and maybe plant all that in goldenrod at some point as well. Oh boy, lady, I don't have time for you today. Tell you what, let's stop by a couple of these. We might throw out most of what we get, but tell you what, let's see if we can dump off some of this stuff. Like that, do a sort. Loot. And scrap. Shouldn't need those electronic components or the cloth or leather. I'll just throw all that stuff out. Just looking for engine. I've never gotten an engine from a... Whoa, Mr. Kappa. Never gotten an engine from a third tier car. I'm not going to say it's not possible, but I don't know if you can get one from third tier. I've gotten one from first and second, surely from second, but I think the third tier just yields scrap and maybe some short iron pipes and things like that. Up an engine, because I know we have one back at the other base. We can just use that for one, but it'd be nice to have a second one to help us along. Make those two cement mixers. Two would be better than one. Junk out we're not gonna need or use. Tell you what, can we make this? We just need the clay and the stone. Okay, I was gonna say we'll make it right now on the way back so they're ready just to plop down. Of course, we really don't have much of anything to put in them. Oh, too much time over here. We're just drawing all sorts of attention to ourselves. Okay, now, back to what we were doing here. Always feel like if I move to the engine compartment. Oh, you know what? I tell you what. We could get... Let's look at how much. 50? This is easy. Oh, actually... Easier yet. Look at that. Whoop. Scoop it up. Oh. Oh, she got out. Take him out so he doesn't break my leg. I have a broken leg most of the time. As it is, there's a dog wandering around over there. Over there. Hopefully Mr. Doggy will mind his own business and hang out away from us while we do this. Don't want to get cut if I can help it. Battery. Don't really need any more of those. That's a good $5.94 though. We'll take it. We shall take it. Boy, if you don't want an engine, you get 30 of them. And then you want one and couldn't buy one. We're talking about buying one. I probably could buy one from the trader, but the heck with the trader. We'll just do this another minute. If I don't get one, we'll just settle with the one and it'll be fine. I thought for sure with the little car lot here, we would most likely find an engine. Another battery. Ugh. Look at that. Three batteries. I'll tell you what we're going to do, though. We're going to stick this battery in our mini bike. Let's see what we have in here now. Oh, we have a 600. All right. So we could almost just scrap all of the batteries that we found. I feel like I'm wasting a lot of time doing this, but I kind of would like to have an extra cement mixer. Like I said, you know, normally another battery. Normally we're getting just engine on top of engine on top of engine. We don't need them. And now that we need one, that's the way it always is. It knows what we're doing because of the parts I have in my inventory. It's like, oh yeah, this guy's going to build a cement mixer. Let's make sure we don't give him another engine. May actually have one in a chest in front of the bookstore in the old town. Have to go over there and look and see. But for sure, look at all those bodies, but certainly we can make one. You know, I know we have the one engine back at the other base. Goodness. Backpack full of the good stuff. Oh, doggy, doggy, don't do it. Another doggy. Oh, we're bleeding. Whoop. Right on out of there. Little danger zone. Oh. I always loot the cars first because I have gotten it. Oh, there's another dog. I swear. I don't want to get caught up with bleeding and having to keep using these first aid kits over and over and over. So we'll just head back to the other city. We'll utilize the one that we had. I guess I can stop by, what time is it, 1332? I can stop by the hardware store because we're going to throw out most of the stuff we picked up from, there's a dog, let's see if we can get him on the bike. Oh, shoot. Oh, jousting. Ah, I won the duel. You know what? What's up now, fool? Looking all funny with no head. Of course, we're probably just gonna spawn more zombies in by doing this, but, oh. I think we actually are spawning in more zombies. Oh my goodness gracious, look at that. Close one. Don't you make this hardware store fall. He was about to blow up. Oh, there's another dog. Okay, so maybe looting the hardware store was not the greatest idea I've ever had. Overwhelmed here. Have to thin the herd every once in a while. Well, she did a little flop right there. Yeah. Broken leg. Overheating. Oh, how did I miss her? Okay, well, that was interesting. Throw this stuff out. Don't need any of that junk. So let's ignore whatever zombie that might be that we hear out there and just get this done. We're looking for auger parts, engines, repair kits. Yeah, rebar. I'll take that. Must be right above us here. All right, so let's go back out, make a quick beeline for the other hardware store. There's an airdrop right there in front of us. So it's street to the left. And we're at 5% gas. Good thing I noticed that. Oh, airdrop, great. Ah, 600 AK stock, we'll take that. We're gonna leave the rest. Do a little sort feature here. I think this is it right here without looking at the map. Pretty sure we were on track. Yep, there it is. Good old working stiffs. Working stiff tool. Nice repair kits. Yeah, might as well throw that radiator in there. That's 9 already. We need those, we'll come back and get them. We'll drop off that headlight in there so next time we come loot this store, maybe we won't be in such a rush. Of course, I think I'm always in a rush when I come through these hardware stores, and I don't ever take half of the stuff that's here. Okay, well, that'll do it for us in here. Untouched remains sitting there. So let's get out of here. Sounds like I hear, oh, I did hear a cop. Well, there's the skate park right there. There's another skate park if we ever decide to turn one of those into a base. Kind of a little neat design, the way it hole in the ground is set up back there. We could absolutely make one of those into a base very quickly. You know, that prison idea is cool and all, but it's just going to take so much time to accomplish something that I could probably do a better job on starting from scratch. You know, we can make ourselves our own prison, but better than the prefab there. And we did loot the one working stiff, or the one shotgun store. We did not loot this one that I recall. Maybe we didn't loot either one. Okay, maybe we did loot this one. It was the other one we didn't go in, maybe. There's a dog on the corner. Down on the corner. Couple. Oh, there's a cop. There's a cop. Coppa! What are you doing? Oh, you son of a gun, yeah. You got me. Oh, he went down. Oh. I am no good with a rifle hip shooting. Come here, doggy. I hear pitter patter little footsteps from all over the place. Comes a dog. Boy, this might have not been a good idea. Well, it looks like the gun store is going to have to wait. There's probably nothing in there for us right now anyway. Let's just get on back. Get on back. Get back. We can loot this car and scrap it real fast. Come on, engine. Need an engine. Need an engine. No whammies. Should be a few more on the ride back as well, unless we have scavenged those as well. A broken leg, you know, I just keep a broken leg. A lot of times I don't even fix those things. I let it heal up all crooked. And here's another car right here. As long as there are no dogs around, we will be good. Come on, engine. Right here in the engine compartment. Nope. Oh, there it is. Nice. I didn't even see it pop in there. All right, so that's our second engine for our two cement mixers. Boy, that was a challenge to get that thing, though. It was not even that great a quality. Of course, the quality doesn't matter on the cement mixer, but you'd think by now I'm scrapping these cars, I'd be getting at least blue or purple engines, and I've been capped in scavenging for a long time, and I would get more of them instead of just one every, what was that, like 15 or 20 cars, something like that. So, all right, we got what we needed. Successful trip back over to the base. Ooh, gotcha, doggy. Got him before he turned around. Boy, all of that running over dogs and hitting zombies and everything else, and we're still only at 79%, or we are only at 79% for damage on the mini bike. Oh, yeah, we stopped there on the way by. It's good stuff. It's very durable. And I think, you know, there's no difference in the mini bike from 100% to 1%, so, you know, really need to do anything. Repair it every once in a while, I guess. As long as it doesn't break completely on you, everything is fine. The guy's overheating again. It's funny, I'm going to go from overheating to freezing here in just a moment. I'll throw the puffer coat back on once we get to where we're going. Probably have to make a poncho for this base, because it seemed like this base I did a lot of overheating down there around the forges, and I can't believe I didn't take any damage on that fall. So easy to get to lose time on this game. You know, my original goal when I sat down today to record this, I said, well, we're going to mine today and we're going to get our cement going. But then as I got into that base, I realized, well, you know, if we're going to mine and set up our base of operations over here temporarily, we need more forges, we need more cement mixers, or we need a cement mixer. And then that turns into this whole other deal. But it worked out for the best. You know, we were able to get a few things done that needed to be done anyway. We'll absolutely take some of our fuel. And we will cut down these trees at some point. Get some more wood to fuel the fire. As a matter of fact, let's go ahead and cut one or two down right now. So I am most likely low in wood. I don't know if I have any wood in here. We'll cut down a row or two. Well, you can just chew right through these things with the chainsaw. We'd be here chopping for a long time with an axe. There's zombies wandering around over there. Since we're going to be over here, I don't see any sense in not cutting it all down and just harvesting all the wood, because we're going to need it. We're going to need it to upgrade all of the rebar. Let's at least get most of it cut down here. Replant it real fast. While we're in this chunk over here. I guess that's a sign that we need to stop right there then. That's fine. That's a decent amount. We've attracted some attention to ourselves here. But I figure since we're over here in this chunk and it's loaded, the trees will grow. And you can never have too much wood. I mean, use it for so many different things. Upgrading those rebar frames, you know, you would be amazed at how much wood you go through just upgrading those. You think concrete, but it takes a bunch of wood too. Hey, lady, what you doing, gal? Get away from me. We're gonna stick our seeds in here like so, and let's see what's in our mini bike here. We'll take the steel down. Add the rebar to that, the forged iron, mechanical parts, gas we can leave in there, and the pillars we can leave in there. Actually, we'll stick the rebar back in there. We're just going to take that with us. We'll take that wood with us as well. And everything else can go in this base down here. See, I may do that. I may prepare, because I guess, tomorrow's the horde day. Okay. So I may just try to prepare this base a little better, and we'll take on with it, because when we took on this base, the horde in this base, everything was default, the spawn. And since then, we've drastically increased the spawn of the zombies. So, you know, we may just try to fix this base up and see how hairy it gets over here, how intense it is to take on a horde in this base. The spawn the way it is. So there's our other engine. We'll stick our let's do a sort here, get a better grasp on what we have. All right, get two of those going, about a minute each. And water. We should have a bunch of water here. I'm gonna make some cornbread, and then we'll have plenty of water. The cornbread and the water will be all we need over here to get us going. Stick that there. Those snowballs, all those snowballs we picked up, I think we put those over here. Yeah, we did. We'll stick those in here and use those at some point. Maybe we throw some sand in one of these forges. So let's go ahead and cancel this and get these two forges created. We'll plop those down, and that'll pretty much wrap up the episode once we plop those. We'll get the... get them in place here. So, this is stone, this is iron. We'll make this one iron as well. Of course, we don't have any iron right now to stick in it. Very little, at least. We're going to throw our steel away into this chest for the time being. We don't need any more springs. Don't need any more oil. Everything's looking good there. Let's get one more of these fired up with stone. Where is our stone? Kind of surprised at the amount of stone we were left over here. Nice. Let me top that one off as well. Good, good, good. A little bit of emergency wood up in there. We'll keep that. A little bit of emergency gas in here. But what we'll do tomorrow is we'll get back on track with the base design. We'll farm up our necessary resources to get that done. We'll plop these down here so we're ready to rock and roll. With the old cement, but pretty sure right for the end of the episode here, let's go take a look at our mine down below, and I don't remember much about it. Let's just see what we were doing down here, what we had accomplished. Seems like I remember this being a honey hole, but maybe we gathered all the resources out of this honey hole. It looks like there might be a little bit left here. Some lead and whatnot. We're all the way down to bedrock too. So maybe we find a new spot down here to mine. And we get ourselves some stone. And the much needed iron for all the steel that we're going to have to do. Maybe we go this way. Yeah, maybe we go this direction. We'll go west. We'll start the hole right here and... see what we can find going this way, but that'll pretty much wrap it up for today. I apologize that we didn't get much more done than Aaron running back and forth. Matter of fact, there's no need for me to even go up or anything. We'll just stay down here, so when we come back next episode, we can just pick up and grab ourselves some iron and stone. But thank you for watching, ladies and gentlemen. I hope you enjoyed. And I'll see you tomorrow.